Niggas been sipping on haterade. I don't really fuck with y'all anyway. Counting up the cash and we celebrate. Then we light up the dank and we levitate. Your girlfriend saying we should get a table.
Good afternoon, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to it. It's another episode of the House of Pablo, brought to you by Pablo, Malume Pablo himself. It's nice to have you guys back after a while. I know I've been MIA, but I've been doing school stuff and I've been doing trying to stay safe, stay indoors as well. So filming's been a bit difficult, but I finally got the time to do it. This episode was a special request from one of my subscribers, so I do appreciate you guys, and you guys are why I do this. So if there are any video ideas that you guys have that you maybe want me to tackle, I'll be more than willing to do it. Just hit me up in the comment section down below, or you can send me a DM in my Instagram, which I'll also link down below. Today we're doing dressing on a budget, so I'll be giving you guys tips and tricks, hacks, how to slice up that budget or stay within your budget when you're shopping for an outfit. We're gonna kick the video off a little differently today. We will be playing a little bit of a game. I'll put up three videos of three different outfits. One of these outfits cost a ridiculous amount per item, and the other costs like half of what my guys usually budget. So I asked a couple of my guy friends how much it is that guys put aside for one outfit, that is for your top and bottom. So about 800 to 1.5 for bottom and for your bottoms and your tops, and these outfits are within that range, but you're never gonna guess which outfit cost the most. So stay tuned and enjoy the video, guys. So we kick this look off with a black polo neck, a black skinny jean, and a creamy trench coat, which looks like it could set us back a bit. So in outfit number two, we have a grey polo neck, grey slim fitted formal pants, and a blazer to finish the look off. So in this final look, we have a flannel shirt paired with white formal pants. So coming in last place is this formal look that set me back only 500 rand. So coming in at second place, this whole look set me back only about 850 rand. And the most expensive outfit, folks, the flannel shirt with the white pants. So the first lesson of the day, I'm going to teach you how to build an outfit. I'm going to give you a cheat code on the foundation of the outfit, and then I'm going to teach you about staple pieces and how you can use them to your advantage while still maintaining your budget. So your foundation is where you can save the most money, because you can opt for a more affordable option and it won't be too evident. Markham's and Mr. Price offer a range of men's bottoms. So you can get formal pants or jeans that look good, look like the real deal, and are affordable. So the cheat code to this is that you can take the pants to a tailor and make them look more fitted and more tailored, which gives them a more expensive look. If you're going for a cheaper option when it comes to your shirts, I would opt that you go for more neutral colors, black, solid black without writing. That gives the look a more expensive look. See, a staple piece is the lead singer, the face of the outfit. This is the main attraction. So this is where most of your budget should go. These are the items I would recommend you get from your H&M's and your Zara's. These are the main attraction, so you need to go all out and splurge a little. So don't be afraid to spend a bit more money on these items. So in conclusion, what I'm saying to you is that there are basic pieces that make an outfit that you can get from Markham's, Mr. Price, Truers for Men, all those other shops. But there are pieces, staple pieces that make an outfit that are unique, that look different. Because your Zara's and your H&M's are more trendy stores in terms of fashion, this way you'll get pieces that are more fashion forward, pieces that look more appealing and that push the margin. So this is why I recommend them for these pieces. If we are being honest, there are some things we can't buy from Mr. Price. And these things are things like leather. Not genuine leather, but I'm talking faux leather that looks genuine. So there are those things that you can't cheat. The things you can't find a cheat code for, that you just need to save up for or get on sale. Let me tell you a story about Tepo. Now, Tepo goes into a shop. He's wearing blue skinny jeans. What does Tepo do? He goes to the jeans section. He picks out blue skinny jeans. Just a different cut here and there. We are all Tepos. You guys are all Tepos. We all do this. We always tend to be more drawn towards things we like, things we, our comfort zone. And I'd like to plead with you today that you should minimize duplication as much as possible. Try to buy more things that are not in your closet, current closet. That gives your wardrobe more variety. You have more options to pick from. You can only style your blue jeans with what you're currently styling your current blue jeans with. You understand me? Whereas if you buy gray jeans or formal pants, you see, there's a variety out there. You just need to explore a little. So this is a black dungaree, which I got from Mr. Price. Only set me back about 200 rands. It's affordable, it's stylish, it's different. So hear me out. What I am pleading with you is that try to give yourself more options. Because you're working on a budget, you can't keep buying the same thing. It just looks like you're wearing the same outfit over and over again. The last thing I want to talk to you guys about today is, when you buy smart. Choose items that look and have class. Choose items that will elevate your look instead of basic pieces. So when you shop around, try to be more vigilant, try to be more attentive. Always think about what you have in your current closet. Never just buy a lime green shirt. Think back to, can I style this with something I already have? Is there anything that complements what I'm trying to buy in my current wardrobe? And don't climb on trends, because what are you doing with your Cavella now? Where is it? It's piling dust in the. We have reached the end of our episode, gents. I hope you guys genuinely enjoyed watching this video, because I enjoyed making it. Did my research, thoroughly looked into this matter, so you guys have the best possible solutions from me. And please comment if you found this helpful. Please comment what stood out for you, and how you're gonna put it to use. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram at Pablo the Stylist. I'll link it down below. Also check out my TikToks. Until next time, stay safe, stay indoors.